Good morning, guys. Let's time to craft again, and I'm gonna make some Mod Podge. I enjoy doing Mod Podge, and I picked up this box somewhere. I don't recall where. And I've been using it as a stand, but it needs to be fixed. So that's one of the things that came to my mind. So what I'm going to do is, I'll show you my funny way of sanding. I actually sanded the edges. I do have some other sandpaper, I just don't have it here, and I actually like using these anyways because I like how they get into the corners and stuff. And then I use these. All the women will know, to get the finer grit of the sandpaper. It works, because I tend to not be doing that much sandpapering. And then to get the sand that I've sanded out, I just use a brush to keep it all clean. I wiped it down beforehand. I'm just going to wipe it down. Remember my favorite wipes that have alcohol in them, and it's gonna need that. Put that in there. It's gonna be a little bit rough because this is very raw wood, but I really like the wood. And I do have some Varathane later that I can use to put a coat on, and that will get rid of that. And I think just keep the wood color for the project. Oh, and what am I going to Mod Podge on? I was happy to see the 2021 Walmart calendar has a bunch of cars, and I've used some of these on some other projects. So I'm just going to pick a car and cut it out, and it's going to be on the inside. My thought for this one is that this is going to be a Father's Day gift. I don't just do girly stuff. I love doing girly stuff, but I try to mix it up. I have some great men in my life that I like to gift things with. I don't know about you, but I think it's super fun to see guys opening gifts. I love people when they post that on YouTube. To me, it looks like their faces turn into little boys. So I'm just going to give myself a nice black bottom. And you know, I'm not worried about being perfect. I have my painter's tape to protect the side. And I'm going to do as thin of a coat as I can. This is just going to make the photo of the car pop out a little bit more. So as thin as possible, and then it's going to dry nice and quick. See? You can do obviously any color, like if you wanted to match up what the picture is gonna be. Because I've got the paint on there, I can go right into that edge. Pinches tape, I mean. Almost. Wood is getting really, really expensive right now. I can't believe it. Hmm. Yeah, just do this. It's a really soft wood. This is not a hardwood project at all. Some people that know wood will probably be able to say what kind of wood it is. I just think it's a nice shape, and I have made Laz one of these, not exactly this shape, just to throw his cigarettes, his lighters, his keys, I don't know how many different kinds of keys he has. Sometimes he throws some extra batteries that he's keeping in there. Random stuff that he's going to need later that he doesn't want to waste. Okay, so I think that'll be good. Some of the center part's going to be covered up. So I want it flat. I don't want any blobs of paint on it. Okay. Again, I have to wash my hands all the time. I don't get this paint on the wood while I'm working on it. Let that dry. It really doesn't matter if I get Mod Podge on the side, so I should be able to take this. Seems like every project I'm trying to peel something off. And I have got the craziest, thickest nails ever. Do not let me get in there. Just gonna be part of it. Remember, if you're watching me, you're watching me because I do not do perfect crafts. I just do crafts. I just like to get things done. And this would have been probably just fine being used the way it was, but I just decided that I wanted to fix it. I could age it later, but I'm going to take that black off there. Even stain it, but I think I like just the plain color that it is. Gonna let that dry. We're gonna pick out a car that's gonna have a nice. I absolutely love Dodge Challengers. That is a super cool car. Orange would be cool. If you got somebody that's a bit likes to hit Porsches. Corvette Stingray. I don't really like the way the trees are causing a shadow. Audi. Camaro. Again, the trees are shadowing on it. This one is super nice too. A Shelby. What do you think? You can see that I have already taken some cars out. This looks like a real muscly car. Chevrolet Nova. Dodge Charger. I made the mistake of calling a Challenger a Charger and I got corrected on that. Ferrari. The wheels are pretty cool on that. Which one do you think I should do here? I'm thinking this one. This one is really cool. Actually, this one looks really nice, but black on black might be pretty hard to see. Yeah, I gotta go for the charger. I'm just gonna tear that out. Challenger. Did I call it a charger again? Oh my gosh. And we're gonna fussy cut it out. And then this is gonna get Mod Podge. I think this is a really cool car. I like the sound of the engines. I like the power. Around here in BC, nowhere, no matter where you go, probably everywhere, you have so many steep mountains. To have a beautiful, strong car like this would make that so much fun to drive. So much fun. I've had some pretty simple cars, but I've also had some pretty cool cars in my day. I like standards, I like trucks, and I think this is going to be a cool car for the organizer. We had a really bad windstorm, so somebody needed to rest. Let's take a look at how that's going to look inside. See how that's going to fit right in there. How simple is that as a craft? Super simple. Ooh, this really comes out quick. Put my Mod Podge in one of these. I just have a fan going, so I'm just gonna stand it up for the fan. Make sure it's dry. Doesn't take long though. You can Mod Podge anything on here. If you have a printer and you print off some family kids' photos or girlfriend photos, that would be awesome as well. If you have some napkins that you like. Sometimes I think it would be very romantic to save napkins and ticket stubs from events that you went to and Mod Podge them on something and prepare that as a gift. I was raised primarily by my older siblings and later on by my dad, so I kind of have tender heart for dads. Okay, let's try to get this in here. I'm just going to eyeball it as I always do. And then just kind of start with one end and come on down. And you know that Mod Podge is dry. It dries clear, I mean. So you can Mod Podge the top as well. Put that to steam down. Not a hard craft. There's lots of things that you probably have that you could Mod Podge onto. And now we have a stand. And I have some Varathane. So I'll probably Varathane the wood parts all the way around. Let's keep that. Okay, anything that goes in it. This back edge is going down. And there you have a cool gift. And I'll show you another Mod Podge. Is that still in? Yeah. I'll just show you another painted box that I finished. That went. I'll just show you this side because the other side has address on it. And once you get your very it's got all of the reinforcements. Once you've got that, or you see that what's happening to my boxes that people get is that they're cutting them down. It's no longer needed in this shape because it's done being nailed. I'm telling you, the reinforcements are done. This is why my painted boxes wind up being kept by people for. One of the people said they've had their painted box for 20 years. Okay, so we're just gonna get that down. Okay. Now you have a stand for things. This is my. So you can keep stuff in your painted box. Here's another. Craft idea. If you have, you know, those Jesus candles that you might buy and then you put them at the gravesite and you let them burn, they're white usually. I just put them in the fridge after. I found these stickers at the dollar store, and of course my jewels, you know how those are. I'm not thinking of this for Father's Day, I'm just thinking of a gift in general. I like to use these as a nightstand, just as a nightlight. Those in, and these are 2 AA batteries, and you have a nice night light. It's not really showing up too good on the camera because you can't see the pattern, but you can see the pattern. I don't know what that's showing up as a flashlight. It's pretty, anyways. I just can't make it. Another at Extra Foods this past year when they did the 70% off sale. I picked up this nice shaped bowl and I Mod Podged it. This is the normal color. Remember, I like to eat things, and I like it because it's bamboo. It's be mushed up bamboo. So I put these napkins on it, and I think what the reason it's still being held on to, and one of the things I just have a suggestion, if you do Mod Podge on white paint and it has black and the black wants to run into that, I had to repaint when I was doing this because that happened. All you do with your very thin napkin is spray it with hairspray, and then that will seal your black, and then you can Mod Podge it on without it getting that way. Alright, so that's probably being saved because I wanted to put another coat of paraffin on it, and I think because of the way that was, I think I wanted to do the coat in a spray method, not. Car wants to get away. You sting car, sorry. You gotta get back in there. So like I said, it's a beautiful hot summer day here. The wind is blowing. So I'm gonna take this outside, and you really should hopefully do barricading outside. And I'm just going to get this whole thing coat of their thing. And that is all she wrote today. And I put this on my journal that I wanted to prepare Father's Day gift. And I completed the craft for Camels and mailed it. It should be arriving in February, on Friday. I'm continuing to keep up with my journal plans. I hope you use a journal, make a journal, and fix a cap for Father's Day. I think I actually might post this as Father's Day. Okay, thanks. Bye.